Hello everyone. Welcome to the September edition of Monthly Fixed Income EV. Welcome Kaustubh.
Hello Mita.
Kaustubh, lot of action on the macro front. Rupee climbing up to 72 kind of levels, fuel prices going up, trade deficit numbers increasing. What's happening? What's the update on the macro front? Both the markets are also quite volatile, both equity and debt markets. So what's happening?
So look, the situation on the macroeconomic front is not all that gloomy as pointed out by you. Why I'm saying this is that, of course, of three big variables, that is growth, inflation and our external factors, I would say over last 2 to 3 months, the good news have come from both growth and inflation quarters, where inflation have surprised downside to the market estimates and growth has surprised both policymakers and economics at large on the upside. As far as the third variable, which is external variable, is concerned, of course, as evident in the rupee move, that's where the market is getting concerned as of now. It is driven, I would say, a large amount of outflows which is happening from emerging markets at large. Fed tightening or the data on the US, I would say, is reasonably strong, and which is giving confidence to US Fed that they can continue the rate hike path. And to some extent, to a larger extent, the firmness in the crude prices, which is what the main problem that India is dealing with. Having said that, I would say that up till now, rupee has just appreciated in line with its peers. So last 4 years, we were one of the best performing currency, and which has impacted our exports growth to a large extent. Now, what has happened over last, I would say, since the beginning of this year, RBI, as the outflow starts from emerging markets, RBI has left rupee to a large extent to find its own fair value. So RBI has tried to reduce the walls, but they are allowing market variables to find let rupee to find its own level. In medium to long term, I think it's a good move that rather than protecting a particular level, in order to make sure that your export competitiveness remains, you are allowing rupee to depreciate, and which at margin over medium to long term is growth inducive. But in short term, it raises concern on inflation front, it raises concern on our external stabilities. And that's why, as a policymakers, we need to be watchful on the path of rupee incrementally. And that's the most important variable that policymakers are watching as of now.
So, Kaustubh, the depreciation is rupee is actually kind of getting transpired in the government bond yields also, showing more volatility, with it hardening by more than 20-25 pips over the last couple of days.
Yes.
And on the other side, similarly, corporate bond yields are also hardening. So what is the policy action that we can expect in light of this? And where do you see these yields getting again range bound, or what is the way forward on the yields?
Look, one need to understand that external stability is very important for any particular country. And among the various tools which is available to policymaker, one of them is interest rates. And the policymakers, because the pace at which the rupee has depreciated, the policymakers most likely will change their inflation trajectory in short to medium term. And that's why markets are, I would say, reassessing the quantum of rate hikes which could come in. We should also take care in mind that 2013 memories are still afresh in our mind. And that's why market, which were anticipating a pause in October policy, have now started penciling 25 basis rate hike in October policy and maybe a possibility of 50 basis rate hike. Now, in our assessment, the scenario now and what it was in 2013 are quite different. Of course, the pace of depreciation is worrisome, but we still think that it's only 25 basis point of rate hike which will come in October policy. And that's why the yields broadly across the tenure and across the rating profile, they have hardened over last 15-20 days.
So, Kaustubh, with more rate hikes expected, yes, and with bond yields also hardening consistently, what is the recommended strategy for investors now? Duration funds, accrual funds?
Look, given that the markets are already factoring 75 to 100 basis of rate hike over next 1 year, and we have a stable local macros in the form of reasonable growth and stable inflation, our sense is that is that these are good times for adding duration to your portfolios. However, one need to be watchful as money manager while adding duration, given that the path of rupee depreciation may not be yet over. And that's why in our funds, we are tactically positioning it, and we are looking for opportunities to add duration. And whenever we find time is appropriate, we'll add duration in our portfolios across categories. Having said that, investors who are looking for the low vols and stable returns, I would suggest them liquid and money market funds. And investors who are looking to have a more of stable and accrual kind of products, we would like to suggest them Aditya Birla Sun Life Low Duration Fund and Aditya Birla Sun Life Short Term Opportunities Funds to invest into.
Thank you, Kaustubh, for Thanks sharing for the update with us. Thank you, viewers, thank for you. Hearing us out. Till the next update, thank you very much for being with us.
Mutual fund investments are subject to market risks. Read all scheme-related documents carefully.